Hello friends, welcome back. As you can see on your screen, we have an Excel file open which has data, and in middle of it we can see a dialog box asking us to enter ID and password. So if we try to close this box by clicking on the close button, which is in the red color, then you can see this box remains as it is. Even if we try to close it, nothing happens to it. So if I try to click anywhere on a data or anywhere in Excel sheet, then also we are not able to access it. So let's enter a password. We will type anything in ID and then in password column. So I am typing 123 here, and same way in password 123. Then we will click on login button. Oops, we got error here, the wrong ID or password. So we will have to reopen it. So now let's reopen it. Now let's enter the correct password and ID. So the ID here is PG all in one, and then enter our password 123456 and click on login. So here we are able to access our worksheet or the file. So in this video we will learn how to create this ID and password. So let's begin. So here we have Excel file to which we want to apply ID and password in order to protect it. So this is the Excel file. Now click on developer tab. Here you can see Visual Basic. Click on that. Now here we need to insert user form, so click on this tab as shown you on your screen. A user form will open up. Now using toolbox we need to draw the label, so click on A icon and draw a box. Now change the name label 1 with ID and password. So type here ID and password. Now click on font, as you can see on here in the video, and change the font size or font style and click on OK button. Now reduce the size of the box and bring it in middle. Now we will draw a text box by clicking on this icon. So these are the text box where we need to type our ID and password. So we will increase the size of this box and we will adjust it to the right hand side. So now copy the same box and paste it. So we will get another box of same size like this. So we will place it below this box. Now again click on A icon and draw the label and name it as ID. So this will be our ID, and place it by the side of the text box 1. So this will be our ID, and same way we will draw another label and we will name it as a password, and we will place beside the password text box. So we will adjust the height and length of the label box according to it. So now here we need to draw a comment box. So this is a toggle button, but we need a command button. So this is it. So click on it and draw below, as you can see on your screen. So now we have the box. So we need to erase the comment button 1 name, and we need to type it as a login. So we will type here as login. So now we need to type some code. I have those code in notepad already typed in notepad. You can visit my blog in order to download it. The link to the blog is in description. So now double click on login button. A box will open with name box 1 user form code. So we need to type the code here. So open the notepad where we have code and copy the code from dim to end if and paste it between private sub and end sub, as you can see on your screen. Now here change the user ID, that is username. We have typed here PG all in one as ID, so cancel it and type your ID. So we will type here 741852 as our ID. So same way we will change password. So we will type here 369258 as our password. Now click on this workbook. Now here we need to type a code, as we want this user form 1 to be displayed as soon as you open our Excel file. So type here user form 1 dot show. Now we need to save this file. I have already saved the file, but I will show you. So go to your main sheet, then click on file, then save or save as, and name the file. While selecting the type, select it as Excel macro enable workbook. Don't save only as Excel workbook. Now we will close all the file and let's see now if it works. So open it. So we will open it. Here we get ID and password box. If we click on the close button, then the box is closing. So we need to add one more code. So let's go to developer, then Visual Basic, and click on user form 1. Then click on login button, double tap on it. So now we need to type a code here. So on the notepad which we have downloaded has another code. So copy it and paste it below and sub. So as you can see, and then copy the and sub from here and paste it at the end of the code. Now save it and let's check again. So close all the file after saving and we will reopen it. So I will double tap. So here you can see, as I open it, if I try to close the login ID and box, nothing happened. It won't close. So our code is working. So now let's enter ID and password. So your ID is 741852 and password is 369258. So if you want to hide this password and want to show it as a star, as you can see on screen this star, then we need to do some changes. So let's log in first, then again go to, after logging in, again go to developer option, then go to Visual Basic, then click on user form 1 and then select the text box 2, and on left hand side you can see its property. If you scroll there, you will find an option called password char. So click on there and type the star character here. Now let's save the file and close. Now let's check it again. Now reopen it. So now we will enter correct ID and let's put correct ID and then our password. You can see the password is displayed in star type character. So if let's type a wrong password and then see what it does. So we will type only one thing and let's click on login button. So it show we won't able to access to it. So we need to reopen it. And let's type a correct password now. So now after reopening, let's type first ID, then our password. So now it's work. So hope you enjoyed this video. Please hit like button because your small support will motivate us to make more video. Thank you for watching. Please comment, subscribe, like, share. Thank you. Have a great day.